Okay, I need to do something. This hotkey for a mute has just been so annoying. Alright, there we go. So let's do two times because the sound effects are kind of obnoxious. So we have Ramos here in the flank. Jujaras, very good sieve. Top Ramen with another great sieve, the Slavs. Ramos' pocket. Franklin 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. With a pocket Franks. Wow, really good sips here. And then Faceless with the Malay. These teams are a little imbalanced, it seems. Unless. Okay, maybe Gray's like really bad or something. Yeah, looking like Gray's. Horrible. So, holy crap, that's bad. So we have Zoe, flank Persians, Gray Silver Demon with the Huns, making farms, not under his town center. T-Bomber here with the Mongols, quite a nice sieve. And then Bruno with the Magyars. Bruno with some good walls here. I like these walls. I might finish this up here. Yep, very nice. Stable, I would have liked it a little bit more forward here, but it's fine. Ramos with some much worse walls, but still fine. Still fine. Faceless, Zoe, yeah, it looks like one team is fishing and the other team is not fishing at all. So it's going to give a massive bonus to the team that I thought would be a little OP, but if you look at Gray. Gray's like not even a player, so it's kind of a 3v4 here. Zoe not paying attention to his scouts at all whatsoever because we have Faceless with some archers. Nice. Faceless doing double damage where he's screwing over Zoe's eco and taking his attention away from the scouts and letting Franklin kill all the scouts. Though, let's check his TC. TC is not working. This is where lower elo players really struggle. Look at this TC, it's still not working here because he's microing 5 archers. There we go. Now we got Bruno here, top ramen up to Castle Age already, which is great. Looks like he's gonna be going knights. Not enough farms for knights though. Only 9 farms, that's not enough for knights. At all. I mean, look at Ramos here. He has 18 farms, and he's feudal. So you'll see he'll make a couple knights, but after a while, these stables are not going to be... not going to be producing, because he doesn't have enough farms. Yeah, this is going to be a massive advantage. Let's see how much fish this is. Yeah, this is 5,000 fish. Just about. 5,000 food, excuse me, that they're going to be grabbing. Bruno Knight, scouts. With a little bit of harass. Ooh, Ramen gets in with the Slav. The Slavic Knights. KTs. He has the armor, but Bruno with the alright, let's slow it down. It's hard to pass with this times 2 here. Oh man, we need to continue making fun of Ramen because this is not He needs to make more farms than this. This is ridiculous. You're Slavs. Literally, your bonus is your farmers work faster. I really like this TC. Franklin, let's check the supplies here. It looks like the top ramen's ahead, but not by much. And this is mostly probably because Gray. Which, by the way, Gray has more farms than ramen. Or they're tied. 15-15. I just know Ramen can do better. Like, his build orders are crisp. He has 3 TCs. But, like, what do you need to sustain 3 TCs? What do you need to make knights? You know, there's really only one thing besides gold. And it's food. Alright, T-Bomb are already with the castle here. I don't like this, actually. When you're Mongols, typically you don't want to go straight into Mega Die because it's very, very, very expensive. And Castle Age Mega Die are not that good. Firemind, what's up, man? Welcome. Ooh, we got some Franklin Knights here. Pressing Zoe. Plus one, plus one. Ooh. Yeah, Zoe getting hurt real bad here. Let's check the bill counts here. 192 to 164, we got 55, 40, 45, 44, 55, 53, 29, 15, 33. So Zoe's really far behind here. He does have fish, which is nice. There you go, there you go. 30 farms, that's much better. There you go, good job, Roman. But yeah, back to, Revomptious, these things are OP as hell. Back to what I was talking about with the Mega Die, when I go, like, say on pocket Mongols, I'll either try and go full boom, like, this is not enough farms from T-Bomber. He does have fish, but I would try to go full boom, like 140 villagers, and then start making Mega Die. And before you make those Mega Die, go either archers or knights, one of the two. Bruno has Magyar, so I probably would have done archers. But it's fine. I mean, it's just preference, you know? But yeah, Zoe really getting screwed over here because he has no pocket to help them. This guy, as I said, this guy is like essentially like a 400 elo player. 500 tops. Maybe 600 tops. Yeah, he's 33 pop where everybody else is like almost at 100. Fort Castle. These guys are doing the perfect thing here, taking out the highest elo player on their team. Yeah, but it looks like these guys are in huge advantage here. Ramen, you do need a gate here, but he'll probably fix that. Ramen's a smart player. I know exactly what Zoe's saying right now. Where's my team? Where's my team? Here comes T-Bomber, but watch this. This is exactly what I'm talking about. These Mega Die are going to get shredded by these archers. Because Mega Die aren't good until post-imp, and you get, you know, all the upgrades. Like, they have only 60 HP. He has no bloodlines. Which means he probably doesn't have husbandry. Alright. No, I thought somebody hit imp. Nope, that was great in Castle Age. Still hasn't made one military unit yet. But yeah, T-Bomber needs to, like, push with Bruno here onto Ramos, and they're defending here. Because, admittedly, Ramen's playing quite well here. He has 32 farmers. I would add more, but 32 is really good. He doesn't have that much room. I would kind of expand out here if I were him. Franklin being pretty aggressive, but that's fine. They're trying to take out the top player on the other person's team. Yeah, Gray making trade cards. It's frustrating. Yeah, that's frustrating when you see your ally making trade cards here. Zoe's completely dead, and that's probably going to be GG. Nope, he's making a town center over here. So it looks like they will continue to fight on 2v4 here. Yeah. Nice. This game is fantastic. They just, it's an old game, but they just remastered it. It's called Definitive Edition. And that's what got me back into it, into playing it. Ooh. Oh, wait, that's, never mind, that's T-Bomber. But I kind of skipped out. I was either going to do some zero mission speedruns or casting or 1v1. I'm not really in the mood to do some team games. So we're just going to cast and then maybe do some 1v1s after the cast. Franklin booming a lot better than he used to, for sure. 73 villagers. Which isn't as good as, like, you know, some of these really good players, but it's still quite respectable. Yeah, this is where... Honestly, if I was... Oh, he can't, actually. I was gonna say, if I was T-Bomber, I would just take Gray's gold. Because it looks like there's not that much gold on this map. It's all in the center. Because look, he has this gold that's gonna run out. He has this gold that's running out. He's not gonna have any gold to make units unless he takes the middle. I wonder if he's gonna figure that out. Because he has over 100 villagers now. That does include these fish, which... Man, what is this? Infantry! Ooh, okay. Interesting. I'm going infantry against what? Nothing really. He's just going infantry. Infantry siege, probably. I would personally go Boyars or Cavalier versus the Mongol player. But Slavs do have fantastic siege. Yep. Yeah, look at all these villagers. These are so inefficient, man. Oh my goodness. Where is... I wonder why T-Bomber's not taking the middle. It's very confusing to me. Because look at this. This is horrible. You have like 5 villagers chopping gold. Yeah, this is GG. They're almost double the supply. Who cares if you're Mongols, dude? Like, the other team has great saves, dude. Gujaras, Slavs, Franks. Franklin with the Franks. Here we go, he finally figured it out. I think. Yeah, okay. Faceless with the top score, but he only has 68 villagers and 13 farms, so his eco is quite bad, but he's done a lot of damage though. He's done, like, he's pulled his weight in gold, but he's not gonna really be able to go up to Imperial Age, so he's gonna lose his entire army here. Here come the disc throwers. Bruno microing quite well though against these. Getting some conversions, splitting his units quite well. But the way you beat these is with siege, which he's making. You need, like, yeah. Magyars has some of the worst siege in the entire game, but you can go Onager. What is T-Bomber doing, though? He has no gold. And he's not even really helping on this side, he's just kind of sitting in his base, not doing anything. Maybe he's trying to just defend against these. He's not even Imperial Age. I wonder why they haven't GG. Let's fast forward here. Let's see. There might be a GG coming soon. Nice micro by Faceless. Very nice micro. Nice micro by D-Bomber too though. Gujaras counter Magyars, don't they? Like, completely counter them with their camel riders. Which are about to be heavy camels. Heavy camel is in, and there he goes. Oh, and then Ramen with the champions. Yep, that's gonna be GG, most likely. If I were the other team, I would have called GG a long time ago, though. Zoe has 24 pop. Gray has 9. Excuse me, 14. He has 4 fire galleys and a spearman. Lul. T-Bomber's still Castle Age as well. This is what I was talking about with the Mega Die. Go Imperial Age first, and then. Alright, he's finally taking the middle. He should have done this a long time ago, though. Franklin with Paladin? Let's go. There's the GG. I did record this for YouTube, but I am